वेलकम बैक गाइस, दिस इज हरीश गोपाले। लेट्स कंटिन्यू द प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ एरे एंड क्लस्टर। दिस इज द वीडियो पार्ट 4 एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू सम टूल्स फ्रॉम द क्लस्टर एंड एरे प्लेट विच इज सर्च अनशॉर्टेड वन डायमेंशनल एरे, स्प्लिट वन डायमेंशनल एरे, रोटेट वन डायमेंशनल एरे, इंक्रीमेंट आरे एलिमेंट, डिक्रीमेंट आरे एलिमेंट, इंटर पोलेट वन डायमेंशनल आरे, थ्रेशोल्ड वन डायमेंशनल आरे, इंटरल्यू वन डायमेंशनल आरेज, डेसिमेट वन डायमेंशनल आरेज। ओके, सो फर्स्ट क्रिएट वन डायमेंशनल आरे। फॉर दैट राइट क्लिक, गो टू द डाटा कंटेनर्स एंड क्लिक ऑन दिस आरे। ओके, देन गो टू द न्यूमरिक पैलेट एंड क्लिक ऑन दिस न्यूमरिक कंट्रोल। So this is double data type array. Okay, then increase the columns and then enter any random number like 54 and what 21. Okay, now go to the array palette and click on this search unsorted one dimensional array and then kept here. Okay, right click, go to the visible item and then click on this caption. Okay. Now guys, if I talk about the function of these search unsorted one dimensional array, so this function will give the search element, okay, which is given by us from starting. For example, you can see I have created unsorted array. Okay, if supposed I want element of this 90, okay, so how I will get the element number of this 90? So simply for that, first connect the unsorted 1D array terminal to this created array. Okay, and now I want element for this 90. So simply go to the element terminal and click constant. Okay, create constant and enter what 90. Okay, simply create indicator. Right click and go to the terminal and create indicator. Okay, then change the position. Yeah, now click on this run button. You can see the element number of this 90 is 6. You can measure the element array measures the element from 0. So 54 present on the 0 element, then 12 present on the one element, then two second element, third element, fourth element, fifth element and sixth element. Even if suppose I can measure, because I know that array always measure the elements from zero. Okay, now suppose I want position of this 56, so simply change 90 to 56. Okay, and then click on this run button. Now you can see the element of 56, element number of 56 is 9. Now again go to the array palette and click on this split one dimensional array and then kept here. Okay, now right click on this function and click on this visible item and click on this label. Okay, now the function of this split one dimensional array is that it divides array index and returns the portion with the element index at the beginning of the second sub array. For example, if suppose I want this array and I want to divide this array from sixth element. Okay, so simply first connect available array to the split one dimensional array. Okay, as I told you that I want to split this array into from sixth element. Okay, so give the element number through the constant. Okay, so enter 6. Okay, and then create indicator first array, create indicator I will get. Okay, so simply create both of the indexes. Now change the position of this first sub array on this front panel window and click on this run button. Now you can see the array element of first sub array, which is from 0 element 0 1 2 3 4 and 5 fifth element, and a second sub array from 6th position to 11th. Okay, now again go to the array palette
okay, and click on this rotate one dimensional array and kept here. Okay, then right click, go to the visible item and label. Okay, now if I talk about function of this rotate one dimensional array, so it rotates the elements from the array, okay, and the position from the array which given by us in the end terminal. That means what, if I will give 5, so this tool will rotate the 5 elements from this array, but last 5 elements. If I will give the element that is 7, so it will rotate the last 7 elements, okay. And in the result, what I will get? In the result, I will get that the rotating elements on the beginning position of the result and the beginning position, beginning elements of this array will grab the position after the rotating elements. Okay, let's do the programming. Simply connect this to available array and then create constant to this end terminal and enter what 5, because I want to rotate 5 elements. Okay, and simply then create indicator here. Okay, create indicator, change the position, come to the front panel window. Okay, change the position. Okay, and then click on this run button. Now you can see this. Now you can see in the result of the last 5 elements from 34, 20, 56, 34 and 21, last 5 element on the beginning of the result. Okay, and the beginning beginning elements from this array after the rotating elements. Okay, so this is the function of this rotated one dimensional array. Understood? Now again go to the array palette, click on this pin button, okay, and click on this increment array element, kept here, click on this decrement array element, kept here, and then cancel. Okay, close this both of the windows. Right click on this increment array element. Now if I talk about the function of this increment array element, so this the function of this tool increase the value of a specified element. Okay, and we can specify it through this index terminal. So, and the function of this decrement array element is that it decreases the value of specified element. Okay, for example, if suppose I want to increase the value of for 0 element, so I need to mention here the element 0. Okay, and if I suppose, okay, so let's do the programming. First connect this tool to the available array, okay, and then connect this, and then create here constant, okay, constant, and enter 0 element, because I want to increase the value of 0 element. Now I want to decrease the value of 1 element, so create constant and enter what 1. Okay, now create indicator, change the position. Okay, again come to the front panel window and change the position. Okay, and then click on this run button. Okay, now you can see the value of first element which is 55. That means what, it increase, and the value of second element on this array output 2, that is 11. That means from 12 it becomes 11, so that it decreases the value. Okay, now guys, if supposed you have multiple arrays, okay, and you want to add each element from every arrays one by one, so how we can do this? Is there any programming to do this, or is there any tool in the array palette by which we can directly add each elements from the array one by one? So the answer is yes, and the element and the tool is, first go to the array palette, and the tool is interleave one dimensional array. Right click and kept here. Okay, now you can see we have already multiple arrays, so simply first, okay, right click on this interleave array and click on this label. Okay, yeah, now it is good.
and simply connect to the available arrays. First I want to connect this terminal to this, okay. Second, and simply create indicator, create here indicator, okay. Change the position. Now come to this front panel window, change the position of this result, okay, and simply click on this run button, okay. Now you, and then increase the column of this result. Now you can see I have first terminal, I have connected with this first sub array, and first sub array contain element 0 have value 54. Now you can see the first 0 element have value 54. Then I have connect second terminal to the second sub array, and second sub array have the value number 1 element have value 90. Okay, I have connect third element to the to the result array last 10 element, and here is the 34 value on the 0th position. Now you can see the second element of this interleave array, that is the value is 34. And fourth terminal I have connect to this array out. Where is that array out? Array out, yeah. Here is the value 55. Now you can see the value of 55. So this is the function of this interleave one dimensional array. Understood? Now guys, tell me, if supposed we are able to add each element from multiple arrays one by one by using one interleave one dimensional array tool, then tell me, is there any possibilities that we can split one array into multiple arrays? The answer is yes, by using a tool, and the tool is Decimate One Dimensional Array. Go to the array palette and click on this Decimate One Dimensional Array and kept here. Okay, I'm going to implement this tool on this interleave array output. Okay, so simply first connect this to the output of this interleave one dimensional array, and then increase the size of this Decimate One Dimensional Array. First right click, go to the visible item and click on this label. Okay, at the time of interleave one D array, I have added four multiple arrays. So now in this Decimate One D array, I want to split this array into four parts, because same like last time. So first create indicator to the first terminal. Okay, this is Decimate indicator, and then fourth create indicator. Come to this front panel window and change the position of this all the Decimate indicators. Okay, this is Decimate array the rows, so that we can see the answer. Okay, and change the position of the Decimate array here. This is the grid position. Okay, and then simply click on this run button. Okay, now you can see the values. This is Decimate array. Where is the Decimate array? Yes, this is Decimate array 1. Here is the values 54, 12, 67, 89. Okay, in my next video, I will explain the cluster, because this is the playlist of array and cluster. Okay, and I think this is enough for array to understand. You should try these tools and all the tools for the programming. Okay, and thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and press bell icon for more information.